In Ephesians 4.
Come on now.
Lying. All bitterness. Wrath. Anger. Rest is in the bosom of a fool. I didn't call you a fool. Clamor, which is quarreling. Sometimes we just like to quarrel. We just like to fuss and fight. You need to stop it. Evil speaking and malice.
Come on now.
Blaspheming and filthy conversation. He told us, put it away and pull it off. There's a thing that we have to put away. We have to pull it off. Because if you in Christ Jesus, you are a what? And I hope you don't put clean clothes on a dirty body. Things he told us to put on. Romans 13 chapter, he said put on Christ. The armor of light. The new man. The whole armor of God. The bowels of mercy. Kindness. Humility. Meekness. Long-suffering. Love. The breastplate of faith and love. And the hope of salvation. He said to put those things on. We play a lot of games in my family. Amen. But this is not a game.
Amen.
All right, come on now.
We treat it like it. But it's not a game.
Right.
Ready or not, here I come. You don't remember when we used to play that? Yeah. Ready or not, here I come. Hide and seek. It was a fun game. But it really is true. Ready or not, he's coming. Ready or not. They were powerless. It works the same way in your personal lives. If we walked free of sin, being led by the Holy Ghost, we walk in God's power and anointing. Take your power.
Come on.
What's giving you fuel? What gives you fuel? Is it the devil? Wrap you up every morning.
All right, my God.
My brother used to say, mad for nothing. Ready to argue every day. Anger, resentment, unforgiveness. And that's what the body of Christ is so guilty of, is unforgiveness. Jumping, hollering, crying, that doesn't cross. He never sung a song. He never skipped a beat. He didn't dance like David danced. He didn't do none of that. I didn't even hear a word. He's quoting the scripture. But the Lord said, this day. Still not my God. Deny yourself. sanctify yourself. Start reading the word of God. And I'm talking about the people that are desperate, because desperate people will do desperate things. Because even with heart disease, and God forgive you, some of it will come back. If you ain't praying like you should, some of those appetites will come back. Come on now. You know what the appetite is for. Because all the devil wants to do, he knows where he's going. He's destined to hell. He don't have a chance. But each one of us have a chance. Take your chance. We don't know. He is a God of another chance. But he's also the God of the last chance. He's also the God of the last chance, y'all. Hallelujah. He's also the God of the last chance. He's the God of another chance. Somebody just say the second chance. Well, I'd have been gone. I'm glad he's the God of another chance. Not just two chances, because I'd have lose my love years and years ago. I'd have been gone, straight down. Three strikes, you out.
Changed it.
And that was peace at home. So we shouldn't be bringing pieces to church.
Amen.
We got the peace.
Amen.
So we don't need pieces. Be quiet today. Because there are some changes happening in our life. There is a true and living God. Because the only world, the only God some people don't see is in us. Some people are never going to come inside the door. You're going to have to take him outside the door. And I'm talking about people that want to live saved. And you don't want to live saved, you're probably going to throw this right on away. But make sure you put it in the same place. Because you might need it. We don't want to give up anything, but what did Christ give up? He was already in heaven.
Yes.
He was already in heaven. But he gave it up for me and you. He took some stripes that we don't have to take. Can you think about a person making a crown of just thorns? Jackie, you're very beautiful. We're putting it on your head. And then when I sit, just not sit there, but I match it down. And then I take my hand, and you have a beard, and I pull the beard out with my hand until it disfigures your face.
Yes, come on.
Then I took a nail with a real foot, and I hammered, the people hammered the nail in the foot.
Yes.
Took each hand. Then he took the sword and pierced inside. The lashes that he took, that his back was open. And he never said,
we can't
take it. Because you checked my hand, I ain't coming back. Because they didn't call my name, I didn't come back. Because I didn't get to sing that song, I ain't coming back. But who are you walking out on? We walk out on Christ, and he didn't do anything for us. Woo! Saying if you in your life gonna lift your eyes up in hell. See that word start working. That word, the word will work. Work the word. The word will work. It'll work. It will work.
Glory.
It'll work.
Hallelujah.
But we don't want to put the word in our kids. You better hear me. The world is so much worse now than when I was a kid. Hallelujah. And being at the prison and seeing all those kids coming to prison, hallelujah, with 30 and 40 years. Come on now. Our kids are not exempt. We got to put the word in them. We got to put the word in them. Put the word in them. And instead, we out there doing what they do on. They need a little bit of this and a little bit of that. They need the word. Mean whatever they gonna do when they get grown. You're not responsible for that. Put the word in them. Put the word in them. Put the word in them. And more than that, live the word before them. Do what the word says before them. There ain't no sense of bringing them to church and you trying to tell them what's right and you ain't doing right. I don't find twerking in the Word of God. All things are appropriate. And when they say he lost his clothes, he lost his outer garment. It was like a cloak that he had on. It was appropriate even when the cloak came off. He was naked. Somebody said, oh my God, but that's all right. Most of the promises of God pertaining to our daily walk are conditional. It says don't walk, but let's get Psalms. And I'm going to let y'all go. Psalms 119. God is so good. And his mercy. Blessed, fortunate, prosperous, and enviable is a man who walks and lives not in the counsel of the ungodly, follow their own advice, their plan, their purposes, nor stand, nor submissive and inactive in the path where sinners walk, nor sit down to relax and rest where the scornful and the mockers gather. We talk about the promises of God, but there's a way to walk. He tells us how to walk and how not to walk, where not to walk, where not to sit. Didn't he? Where not to stand in the way of people. And sometimes when we're in the way, we get so caught up in ourselves. And let me tell you, just because it's not your way, don't make it wrong.
Amen.
Because people do it a whole different way, don't make it wrong.
Amen.
Can I say that?
Amen.
Because sometimes we get that way. It doesn't make it wrong. We're standing at this time. Today we want to deal with ourselves. Look at yourself. Look at what you play in your house. If your house is torn from the floor up, what part do you play in that? I don't care if you're in there by yourself. You know who it is, right? What part do you play? You're somewhere in the equation. Part of the problem or you're part of the solution. Somewhere in the equation. It's funny, you can see a kid, if they're doing something bad, the mama say, "You just like his daddy." The daddy say, "You just like his mama." But if it's something cute, oh, they do. I was like that when I was a kid.